Hello and welcome to today's episode of the International Daily Roundup by People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the major news developments from around the world. Let's take a look at our headlines first. Report finds BJP-linked app spreading hate in India. Tunisian court to prosecute 19 opposition politicians. Netherlands ends support to outlawed Palestinian NGO. And Iran and South Korea hold talks on blocked funds. In our first story, a major investigation has revealed the use of a secret app to spread hate and right-wing propaganda in India, called TechFog. It has links to the political operatives of the ruling far-right Bharatiya Janata Party. These findings are part of a two-year-long investigation by the news portal The Wire. TechFog allows operators to hijack trends on social media websites such as Facebook and Twitter. This is done through features to auto-retweet and auto-share posts. This works to artificially boost extremist political narratives. Another disturbing feature is the user's ability to hijack supposedly inactive accounts on WhatsApp. TechFog can then use the account's phone number to message a person's contact list. The app also contains a detailed database of private citizens. This is categorized on the basis of religion, occupation, gender, political inclination, and even physical attributes. Operatives can use this database to automatically reply to individuals or groups. This can be done either through connecting a Google Sheet or by auto-generating keywords and phrases. The Wire investigation found that most of these keywords were abusive or derogatory. Finally, TechFog also allows its users to swiftly delete or remap all existing accounts. The app's existence came to light in a series of posts by an anonymous Twitter account in April 2020. The user claimed to be a former employee of the BJP's information technology cell. The sources named the party's current state election manager, Devang Dave, as their immediate supervisor. The Wire report has also found two private companies with links to TechFog. Among them is Persistent Systems, which has been contracted by the Modi government for services in the recent past. In our next story, a Tunisian court is set to prosecute 19 opposition leaders for committing electoral violations in 2019. Among them is President Kais Saied's predecessor and prominent critic, Moncef Marzouki. Four former prime ministers have also been summoned. The court of first instance is pursuing charges including illegal campaigning through social media. Also included in the list is the head of the Workers' Party, Hama Hamami. The party has accused President Saied of indulging in political propaganda against the opposition. It issued a statement saying that these actions were part of moves taken since the political coup in 2021. The persons listed by the court will be asked to appear before a correctional chamber on January 19th. The prosecution has based the charges on a report by the Court of Auditors. It was part of a series of inquiries into allegations of fraud during the 2019 elections. The document is also linked to the campaign of President Kais Saied to irregularities. However, his name is absent from the prosecution's list. The president will have legal immunity till the time he is in office. Opposition leaders in Tunisia have denounced Saied's actions as a constitutional coup. The president dismissed the cabinet and suspended parliament on July 25, 2021. He has been ruling by decree after suspending parts of the constitution in September. He has announced a constitutional referendum to be held in July 25 this year and fresh parliamentary elections at the end of the year. We now move to the Netherlands, which has halted funding for the Palestinian Union of Agricultural Work Committees, or UAWC. It is among the six Palestinian organizations declared as terrorists by Israel. They were declared as terrorist organizations acting on behalf of the Popular Front for the Liberation of Palestine, or PFLP. The UAWC was set up in the 1980s to help farmers affected by illegal Israeli settlements and attacks in the occupied West Bank. Before halting its donation, the Dutch government conducted an investigation into the UAWC. It found no evidence of financial flows or organizational unity with the PFLP. It found links at the individual level with 34 employees being members of the PFLP at some point. The UAWC has denounced the Netherlands' decision for being based on a political conditionality. It is important to note that Israel has refused to provide evidence behind the terrorist designation. The sixth group in question had sent a letter to the military in December demanding the disclosure of documents. Israel claims that the core of the evidence is based on classified information. This is a clear violation of due process rights. The banned Palestinian groups includes Defense for Children International, Adamir, and Al-Haq. These organizations work to document Israeli occupation's abuses and also provide critical support to Palestinians. And now for our final story, Iran has held talks with South Korea to demand the release of its frozen assets. Officials from both the countries met in Vienna on January 6th. Seoul is holding funds worth over $7 billion to pay for oil shipments from Iran. The transfer has been blocked under unilateral US sanctions. Top Iranian official Ali Bagheri said on Thursday that the sanctions could not justify the non-payment of debt. Iran has raised this issue repeatedly and has also placed restrictions on imports from South Korea. Thursday's meeting took place on the sidelines of the eighth round of talks on the 2015 nuclear deal. Iran has demanded the complete lifting of US sanctions along with a period of verification. It is also seeking guarantees that the US will not withdraw from the deal in the future or reimpose sanctions. Following talks on January 7th, the French foreign minister stated that progress had been made. Iran's foreign minister, Amir Abdullahian, also told Al Jazeera that they had heard good words from the US. Iran is holding official talks with China, Russia, the UK, France, and Germany. The US is participating in the negotiations indirectly. The funds frozen in South Korea will reportedly also be discussed in Vienna. That's all we have time for today. We'll be back tomorrow with more news from around the world. Until then, keep watching People's Dispatch.